Okay, some geometric series, when you start to add them up, and when you take an infinite number of those items in a series, diverge. And by that I mean that the sequence just keeps getting bigger and bigger. For example, if you have 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus, and you keep adding more numbers to infinity, that's going to be a pretty big number, and that sequence getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger never settles down to a single certain value. It just keeps growing in size. We call that divergent. But some infinite geometric series actually converge. As you add more and more and more numbers in, it actually gets closer and closer and closer to a certain value, which might seem a little counterintuitive right now, but it does actually work, and let me show you one. And again, by converge, I mean settles into a single value. So if you take 2 and you add 1, well, you started with 2 and now you're at 3, and then you add a half. So the R value we're looking at here is 1/2. Well, now you're at 3.5. And then you add a half of a half, which is a quarter. So now you'd be at 3.75. And if you added another half of a quarter, which would be an eighth, you'd end up at 3.875. And now this is going to get a little bit difficult for me to just rattle off. But if I added a half of an eighth, which is a 16th, and sorry, this should be a list down here, I would end up at 3.9375. And if I add 1 over 32, and then 1 over 64, oops, 1 over 64, and 1 over 128, then I'm going to get some more terms. In this case, by 128, I will have 3.9921875. And if I keep going forever, well, forever's a long time. What do I get to? Well, let's look at this pattern. 2 to 3, 3.5, 3.75, 8, 5, 9, 9, and a bunch more decimal places. Maybe this gets to 4. And in fact, it does get to exactly 4 when you keep adding in these numbers forever, which is pretty crazy. It's pretty interesting how this works. Well, this only happens sometimes. It didn't happen in the first case, but it certainly happened in the second case. And the rule to if it will converge or diverge is based upon the R value. In the first case, when the R value was 2, the numbers just kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And here, where the R value was 1/2, the numbers that we add are smaller and smaller and smaller, getting closer and closer and closer to just adding 0, essentially. So it gives the number, the sum of the series, the ability, when you're adding just smaller and smaller numbers in, to eventually almost stop adding numbers in, and it will converge to a certain value. So if an infinite geometric series has an R value bigger than 1, then it will continue to grow. So if you're multiplying by 2 or 3 or 4 or even 1.1, then it will continue to grow. So an infinite geometric series got to be infinite, has to be geometric, and it will diverge if the R value is bigger than 1. It's also true that if the R value is less than negative 1, so if you multiply by negative 2, multiply by negative 2, multiply by negative 2, you'll see a different kind, but still a type of divergence. What we're also interested in, though, and are these kind of cool ones that I have in here in blue just above, where it converges. And it will, if it diverges when the R value is bigger than 1 or less than negative 1, then we don't want to have an R value of 1. That's kind of boring. Then in between negative 1 and 1 is when it will converge. It will converge again if the R value is bigger than negative 1 and less than positive 1. And if it converges, then there's got to be a sum. Then you have to be able to add it up. And the sum of an infinite series, so the number of terms is an infinite series, is simply the a value divided by 1 minus r. So in the case where I had 1 plus 2 plus, and I then did, sorry, 1. In fact, sorry, I had 2 plus 1 plus 1/2 plus 1 quarter, and I kept adding this up. The a value is 2, the r value is 1/2, and I'm going for an infinite series, so the sum of this infinite series, sometimes we don't write that little infinity down there, when we're dealing with infinite ones, is 2 divided by 1 minus 1/2, and 2 divided by 1 whole take away 1/2 is 1/2, 2 divided by 1/2 is 4. And so we can see that number that we could see through more of a listing process above. So let's try a couple examples of this. So let's see if we can find the sum of this infinite geometric series, 1 and then add 1/5 and 1 over 25 and 1 over 125. So the r value, again, I take two terms in a row, so 1/5 divided by 1, or it's just 1/5. The a value is 1, and so now I can just say, okay, well, the sum is the a value divided by 1 minus 1 over 1/5. I can plug this in on a calculator. I could use decimal places if you enjoy decimal places a little bit more. That gives me 1 over 0.8, and calculating this gives me 1.25. So this series that goes on forever actually equals a value that is a nice converged number of exactly 1.25. Let's take a look at one more. Let's find the sum of this infinite geometric series. Okay, so the a value is 4, and our r value is, so I have to take two terms that are in a row, 4.04, and divide it by 4, and I get 1.01. Oh, wait a sec. We learned before that this r value has to be between negative 1 and 1, and if it's bigger than 1, it will diverge. So in this case, it looks to me like I don't have a number between negative 1 and 1. I have a number bigger than 1, so I don't really need to do any more calculations. The sum of this thing is impossible to find because it just keeps getting bigger, and this one just diverges. So don't bother getting tricked into calculating something that you actually cannot calculate. We cannot apply the formula to something that does not have the condition, in this case of r being between negative 1 and 1. Okay, we'll get some practice in class. See you there.